Hi everyone, my name is Professor Katie King. Welcome to the English 103 Fall 2020 semester online. It's nice to e-meet you all, or it will be nice to e-meet you once the first discussion board is completely finished. Once I have, you know, attendance all kind of set and going and everything. In this video, I'm just going to kind of introduce myself quickly, and then we'll go to the Canvas page. I'm going to walk you through kind of a quick navigation so that you can notice the things to look out for, the things that you might not necessarily need to use, things you can, you know, you might use once, things you can avoid, all that good stuff. I will go over the syllabus, and then I will show you the discussion boards that if they are not posted yet, because sometimes Canvas doesn't let us post anything until the semester officially begins, and this video is being made before that. So I'll show you how to access that so that if you want to get a head start on it, you can. So I guess I'll introduce myself. Again, my name is Katie King. You may have seen it as Catherine King or Katie King, depending on how you signed up for the course. This is my fourth year of teaching full-time at Fullerton College. I have taught, I think I'm going on my 12th year of teaching now. I've taught everything from second graders to seniors at a four-level private university. So the tagline I always like to tell my students is, I know kind of where you're coming from. I used to teach high school for a long time, and I know where you're going because I used to teach at a four-year at Loyola Marymount in LA. So that should help you. And also I've been teaching at the community college level going on my sixth year. So I, you know, I'm not telling you this to toot my own horn, beep, beep, but I'm telling you so that you feel a little more safe and a little more comfortable. I know that this format is perhaps not ideal for everyone, but I'm going to do everything I can within the scope and parameter of this course to make sure that all learning styles, all learning needs are addressed and met. And, you know, anything that might be challenging or difficult, particularly in these challenging and difficult times, is made less so. So please be aware of that. All right, so I'm going to switch it to a share screen. You're going to see me do this in a lot of my videos, just so that I can show you how to navigate, you know, an assignment or a web page. And you should still see this, you know, bloated mug in the corner of your screen somewhere. So just bear with. I hope you can hear me okay today. This is one of those 95 degree days that I'm recording this, so I have my fan going. If anyone is having any trouble with perhaps hearing these videos or the closed captioning that appears at the bottom of the screen, please let me know immediately and I can address that so that, again, we're all learning as conducively as possible. Okay, so I'm going to take it to a share screen. And I think the first thing I'll show you is just my Zoom page because it actually has my meeting ID on it. And the meeting ID is helpful because if you know this ID number, 478-447-4211, and you're trying to find me, all you have to do is go to zoom.us, that's Z-O-O-M, as in Mary, .us, as in the United States. And you can use this ID right here to find my Zoom office hours. This is an online class, so I will not be having synchronous Zoom or Teams or Skype classes, but I do have office hours on Zoom if you ever want to come and have sort of virtual face-to-face discussions with me. So that's the meeting ID. I think if I, oh yeah, never mind. So I will go then to the web page. Oh yeah, everyone, COVID-19, as if we haven't heard anything enough about that. Anyway, I'm going to go to our class webpage. Whether you're in CRN 1116 or 11666, metal, or you're in 11745, this page is going to look exactly the same. So don't worry about the CRN right now. If you're in 103, your page should look identical to this. And again, if you try to view this before the 23rd, You might not be able to see some of these things, but after the 23rd, you should. So I'm going to start with the home page. If you look at my cursor here at the top of my toolbar, it'll say home. I'm on a laptop. And what that means is my navigation might look a little bit different than yours does. I know a lot of people use their cell phones to access readings, to do assignments. I don't know how on this gigantic green float, you know, green and blue floating orb through space, people can type on these tiny little things. But if that's how you do it, great, as long as you're doing it. So your navigation bar might not be here. It might be like on a page on your phone. It might be up top here. So if you're on a phone, if you're on a different type of computer or a PC, it might look a little bit different. It may not be exactly identical to this, but once you get to where those places are, all of the content should be the same. And one gentleman who I would like to introduce you to, since I'm gonna be teaching from home, this is my dog Lionel. He is a 6-year-old basset hound, both the love of my life and the bane of my existence. I also have a 5-year-old pit bull named Coleslaw. If you ever hear kind of barking or an abrupt, loud dog-like noise in the background, it's not me, hopefully. It may be them, especially if you're in a Zoom meeting with me. So I just want to preface with that because sometimes my dogs have a tendency to bark really loudly and I have to leave my window open sometimes because it's warm. And, you know, just wanted to give you a heads up there. So since this is Introductions Day and we're doing this remotely, you know, I figured I'd introduce you to the other two beings that you'll be sharing this course with, my dogs. All right, so anyway, back to our course navigation page. So this is our homepage. It's very simple. I'm not a fancy web savvy person, to be honest with you. So it's got the basics. And where I can, I'm gonna put it in student view so that it looks as much like what you're gonna see as possible. So it just says, you know, silence. It just says, welcome to English 103. Where do I start? You'll go to the modules. You should see this little module button right here again in that toolbar. So for every week, all the assignments, the online readings that aren't in the textbook that is required, my web teach videos, other videos related to the course, etc. Those will all be on the modules. And what you may find is because I copied this from a summer class and just kind of, you know, reconfigured it to fit a 16-week schedule, you may find like stuff that says like due on July 15th, you know. Don't worry about that. It's just kind of working itself over from the summer course that I'm reconfiguring it from. So just follow the syllabus. You're gonna be totally fine. And I'll show you the syllabus in a moment. In terms of contact information, here's like kind of how I interact with you since we're not face to face. So keep these types of contact interaction in mind with me. Again, this is not a synchronous class, so there's no like 2-day-a-week meeting schedule. I do still conform my discussion boards to like a 2-day-a-week schedule, but I'll show you what that looks like in a moment. The only face-to-face online interaction you'll have with me are optional Zoom meetings, which I highly recommend you come to, right? My office hours that are totally optional, but totally open to you every week. And we will have one mandatory conference meeting, sort of mid-semester. And that will be flexible with the students' schedules, you know, at times where you can show up and all that stuff. So don't worry too much about that. There's my faculty contact information here, my name, my Fullerton email, my Zoom link, my Zoom office hours. So basically when you come to my Zoom office hours, what you're gonna see is exactly what you see right now. Like me standing on the other side of the standing, sitting, lounging, you know, hopefully not face down in a pillow crying my eyes out, but who knows, right? It's the time of COVID-19. But this is what essentially you'll see when you click that link and I accept you into my Zoom room. some note about accessibility here. I'll talk more about that when I get to the syllabus, but please be aware of the accessibility, of your own accessibility needs. And if you require specific accessibility needs, those need to be brought to my attention as soon as possible. Again, I'll talk more about those when we go over the syllabus. So this is the homepage. Every week I will send an announcement. You should have gotten one tonight that was probably a little confusing because it said like, hey, there's a video up and blah, blah, blah. This is the video that I'm talking about. So I'm actually making it right now. So it says the video, the discussion board. Again, if you don't see the discussion board yet, it's because it may not post until Sunday because of the sort of Canvas, you know, when you can post for the new semester rules. But I have a feeling I'll probably just be emailing it to you guys so that you can access, you know, so you can have a little head start if you need it for this week, because everybody's going, ah, school starting again, right? I didn't even get a summer. That's going to translate really well in closed captioning, by the way, I can already tell. So keep all that in mind. Then we have the syllabus, which you can find either on the syllabus button on the navigation panel, or you can find it under module one, which if you click on the modules button on the navigation panel is the next one underneath the syllabus, right? So the very first thing under the very first module is the syllabus. So you can either go here or you can click on the modules. And it's right there. It's under day one, number one, item number one. So since I've shown you how to get there, we can just click on that. And then it'll pull up the syllabus in this little window right here for you. It should, if you don't have the proper, like, you know, apps or attachments or whatever on your phone or your laptop, you may have to actually download the file, but it should kind of pop up into this little window here. So depending on how you want to access it, just keep that in mind. Before I go over this, and don't worry, I'm not going to read every single letter of every word in this 12-page Bible length freaking thing, right? I'm not going to do that. But I'm just going to kind of touch on the main points so that we're all on the same page. But I do want to bring your attention to this toolbar. What you're seeing right now is kind of a limited version of this because, I haven't posted everything. But you will see, and I'm going to leave student view really quickly so that you can see these things from my faculty view. If you look at mine, I get a lot more cool stuff, right? Because I'm a boss, right? I'm a teacher. So I get like lockdown browser and you do it and I get to take attendance, fun stuff, right? I don't do rubrics, so I think my grading policy in and of itself is pretty self-explanatory, and I prefer to explain things in my way as opposed to like boxes on a chart. Nothing wrong with that, but it's just never worked for me. So I don't do rubrics, but you'll see things as the course progresses. You'll see in your navigation bar, you'll see quizzes pop up when we have the midterm. You'll see discussions when we start doing the discussion board posts. You may even see them now. And again, if you think the dates are like weird and wonky, it's because a lot of them are transferred over from summer. And I kind of revise them week by week as we go. You'll see assignments. The pages option you will see, especially for those of you who do require accommodations, this will be helpful because it has some of those additional accommodations for things like sight and hearing that you can access through pages. Files are like all the files that I've ever posted for this course, and I've been teaching this course at least on Canvas for like 5 years, so there's a lot in there. It's probably the Wild West in there, so you can look through it, but it's kind of like the haystack, whereas modules is where it's all like kind of neatly organized, so keep that in mind. Your grade button, as you get graded, you'll see your grade button pop up, and then that's pretty much all of it. But just know, again, if I go back into, can I go back into student view? Maybe I can't. Just know that on this toolbar, that again, this is mine, yours looks a lot more limited, but yours will look fuller and fuller kind of as the next couple of weeks progress and the course gets going. So just keep that in mind. All right, so I'm gonna go through this syllabus. Again, not gonna read the whole thing because syllabus day is boring enough as it is. We all know this, right? I'm not really blowing anyone's mind by saying that. So this gives you, what this does do is like anything basic you need to know for the course, it's kind of like the owner's manual of the course, right? And it's also the thing that you agree to. I don't know if students realize this, but the syllabus, the reason why we go over the syllabus on syllabus day is it's essentially kind of like a contract. And you don't have to sign it because just your presence in the course is your implicit complicity with what's going on, your implied consent, if you will. But you should know that, right? You should know that by following this syllabus, by knowing what's in it, by agreeing to be in this course, you're following the rules that I set forth in here. Now, that doesn't mean I'm going to put in some crazy rule that is not only illogical, but abusive or whatever. But what it means is that, you know, the rules apply to everyone equally. And so I cannot bend those rules for one person if I then do not bend them for the entire class, right? And I'm not really apt to do that because I think my rules are pretty fair to begin with. So this is kind of like your contract, your owner's manual, right? It has the information, my name, the CRN numbers, my Zoom contact that I told you about, my contact information. I also have an Instagram account. If anyone's interested in following me on Instagram, it's totally optional. It's not part of your grade, but it's helpful in that, like, when I can best remember, I post reminders about due dates and I post little helpful, you know, little Instagram pages about stuff that I think are cool. So it's Prof King FC English on Instagram. So if you're interested in following my professor account on Instagram, there it is. I will not follow anyone else. I do not follow students on my account other than former students who have gone on and graduated because the ethics are murky for me and I don't feel very comfortable doing that. So I don't want you to feel like you're being watched or you're being like followed, right? It's just for you to follow my page that talks solely and specifically about course related content issues, updates, etc. All right, table of contents. This is going to be helpful because, again, this thing is long. So if you want to skip to a certain page, you can just see where it lies in the table of contents and then skip to that page. These are pages 2 and 3. I kind of like this. I like that they're all mapped out for us, right? In this course, we have 2 required texts. Some of you have already emailed me about the required texts. They look like what you see here. But a couple of things I'll say about that. I don't care what version of the text you get. You know, if you're worried about money, if you prefer to read online text as opposed to print text, like none of that matters to me as long as you have the proper text and you can get all the information. So like Tolentino, you could get the paperback version. You could get the hardcover version. I have a really weird version. I have a version that was published on the Indian subcontinent before it was published here. So if yours looks like this, the chapters, I go by chapters and not by pagination, so there won't be a problem. Whatever version you get them in, used, online, you know, whatever is fine. As long as you're following along with the readings, the material, the assignments, etc. Everything's an argument is in its 8th edition, but for textbooks, one thing I always tell students is, you know, I'm not going to say it's a racket, but so what textbooks do is like they'll add like half of a new chapter or, you know, a new picture in one chapter, and then they'll update the whole book, and 99% of the information that was in the previous edition 7 or 6 or 5, isn't new, right? A lot of this information that we're talking about in rhetoric, in argument, is up to 3,000 years old. So in 2020, the issues change, right? Like the things that we argue about change, but the skills that we apply to argument, those don't necessarily change too much. So what I'm saying and telling you all that is, like, if you get an earlier edition of the book, as long as you can make up for the missing pieces that are found in the newer editions, that's also fine with me. You know, if you want to get the sixth edition because it's $7 on an ebook page or whatever, like, knock yourself out. I don't mind. So again, as long as you're keeping up with the readings, you're keeping up with the assignments, you're doing the work, I don't care what the format or the book looks like, as long as it's the same one, right? You know, read over kind of the stuff that I require and recommend. Like, you clearly need internet access. I know last semester in the spring they were doing access. You know, you could like go to a parking lot on campus and get internet access. They had laptops for rent, which they're doing again this semester. You know, there's all kinds of stuff that we're trying to do to accommodate this weird new world experience as best we can. So make sure you have that. I think some libraries are open. You could like sneak into a library, a local library, and get a few hours, just wear a mask. You'll need that. You'll need to take notes. You need to save your materials. You do have access to Microsoft Office 365 and Google Docs as a student on this campus. If you go to Canvas, they'll give you announcements and sort of guide pages on how to access those. So keep that in mind. Course description, student learning outcomes, and instructional objectives. The state makes me put that in there so that they know I'm not just like sitting here on Zoom talking about my dogs for, you know, 6 hours twice a week. So I'm just going to skip over that. If you want to read it and make sure that I'm doing all those things and you've learned all those things by the end of the semester, be my guest. If you have an axe to grind and, you know, like want to get me fired, you can always be like, Professor King didn't teach me instructional objective M. And I don't know, like file a complaint, whatever. So there's those. Save all your work. We're at saved work here, just FYI. Save all your work. And the reason why is this. Professors are clearly super brilliant people, right? But we're also human and we're also fallible. So what that means is, you know, if there's anything that gets lost on my end, you have a record of it. And at the end of the semester, when everyone's freaking out about their grades, that is super important, right? So save all your work. For late work and for makeup work, it's a different rule for day-to-day assignments versus major assignments. For major assignments, for any essay you submit to Canvas, it is counted as a day late if it's not submitted by 11:59 p.m. on the due date. For every day that it's late, it is deducted a letter grade for a major writing assignment. After 5 days, it essentially becomes an F. So I don't accept them after 5 days of late work. And know that computer problems are not a valid reason for not turning things in on time. Again, I know not everyone has the same, access to certain things like the internet and computers and all of that, and it's unfortunate. But there are things like rental computers, internet access on campus, and I will be keeping you as aware as I can of all those things as they come down the chute for me. One smart thing to do would be to follow the Fullerton College president's weekly emails, as well as the Full Call, FULLCOLL Instagram page, because they give you great updates on all that stuff and so many more things. So, you know, if you need information like that, check it out. For day-to-day assignments, because of sort of the pacing of this course, if you don't submit a discussion board on time, the portal closes, you can't do it. I have, you know, gosh, I'm going to have about 120 students, you know, this semester. There's no way with, let's say, the 20-25 discussion board type assignments that I have in each class, so I multiply 120 times 25, right? That I can just go chasing after, like, oh, this is late and that's late. It's just, it's done. I gotta grade it. We move on, right? So for day-to-day assignments, you can't make those up. You should still get caught up if you're behind. Clearly you need to for the class, but you can't make up the, you know, the typed assignment. And I'll move my little screen here in case you can't see that. I don't accept emailed work because, again, that paper trail just becomes a nightmare. And so to nip it in the bud, I just say, do the work that is required of you when it's due. It's that easy, right? We can make it really simple by just doing that. And plan for disaster ahead of time. No one was anticipating COVID-19, right? But some people planned for a global worldwide disaster better than others. And, you know, they're doing better now because of it. And so in any way you possibly can plan for disaster in a very unpredictable world that we live in right now, it's going to help you. It's going to behoove you as much as possible. So do it. If COVID has taught you nothing else, it's to plan for disaster ahead of time. All right, so attendance and participation. How do I check attendance and participation? I do it through your discussion boards. That's why I do these discussion boards, as you'll see in a moment. I do them essentially kind of twice a week. So that's how they'll be counted. Every discussion board you don't do, not only do you lose points for not doing the discussion board, but that's also counted as an absence. So make sure you're keeping up with those, because if you accrue more than two, you could potentially be dropped from the course, especially early on in the course. Especially early on in the course, right? So keep that in mind. All right, so where am I going? Come on, computer. There we go. Follow the rules of netiquette. Again, this is kind of a newer thing, unless you've taken an online class before, but in the same way that you're expected to be kind, respectful, and thoughtful within the classroom setting, please do the same thing online. You know, you've all heard of like the Zoom bombers, or people kind of like, you know, I don't know if you've heard the term like net banging, right? Like people who think, or keyboard warriors or whatever, like people who think they're real tough behind a screen and just say like ridiculous, atrocious things. We're still in a college environment and that's not going to be accepted. So if I see that, I have to address it in the same way I would items of that nature in real life, IRL, right? So if you have any questions, or if you're unclear on what netiquette is, just go to online.fullcall.edu/netiquette, N-E-T-I-Q-U-E-T-T-E, and read those rules there. My grading policy is listed here. You are gonna have four essays. So, awesome. We've got essentially 4 months, so it's like an essay a month. We also will have a mandatory virtual conference meeting. You do have those day-to-day online discussion board type assignments. And for those of you worried about missing assignments, especially major assignments, know that I will have minor extra credit opportunities. I'll also have a thing called the Hail Mary assignment, which allows you to make up a major writing assignment. So there are interventions in place, even if you fall a little behind. And the other thing I can say is communicate with me. Communicate, communicate, communicate. I can help you a lot more if I know what's going on. I can't always give everyone a yes, right? Like that's not the world that I inhabit. But I can help people a lot more if I know what's going on than if people just sort of passively withdraw and disappear and I have no clue, right? So be communicative. It's going to help you, not just in this class, but in all your classes. All right, and then there's some information about the Academic Support Center. Again, it's always a good idea, particularly if you struggle with writing, to go above and beyond, especially if you want that above and beyond grade, the A, right? It's almost imperative that you do these things outside of the class. Like tutoring, the writing center, student support services, where the link is down here, the skills center, right? All those things. So keep that in mind. Okay, now I'm gonna go, I hope on your screen you can see that I move my face out of the way for this stuff. If not, sorry in advance. So let's go to the class schedule. I'm not gonna go over the whole thing with you, but I do want to make you aware of what this is and what its function is, because you have, let me see, you have a few pages of it, right? So here's how I've set this up. In the first column here, you have when assignments are due, right? We don't have class meetings, but you will have discussion board due dates, and they are listed here in the left-hand column, okay? For all due dates, unless specified with blue highlighter, and day of the week capitalized letter, for all due dates, the majority of items will be due on Thursdays and Sundays for this class. So again, twice a week, Thursday and Sunday due dates. That includes both discussion boards, those day-to-day assignments, as well as major assignments. The second column, you'll see at the top, it says before completing the assignments, make sure you've read the following, right? So the second column is all of the readings that you have to do, from both the textbook, right, the Lunsford textbook, as well as the Canvas online readings that are specified in the syllabus, which readings are on Canvas. And when we get to it, trick mirror, right? Let's see if I have, I'm just gonna see if I have the Lunsford textbook right here with me. A really old one. This is the 6th edition. This one's red. The 7th edition is like a lime color. And then the 8th edition is that aqua blue color. But this is the textbook, Lunsford, Everything's an Argument. Again, it's probably a different color for you. This is Trick Mirror. And then anything else that is specified here that's not in one of those two books, in parentheses, it says on Canvas, that's where you'll find the reading. Okay. So that's the second column here. The third column is the assignment that's due for that day, okay? So for example, where I said, unless specified by blue highlighter, on your very first discussion board is actually due on a Tuesday. It's due on Tuesday, August 25th. And the reason for that is for me to take roll and to drop any students who are not actively enrolled and engaging in the course. So that's why I put that one a couple days early, because I have to, you know, submit that to my department and the college and all that, in case people just aren't showing up online. So for the very first discussion board assignment, it's actually due on a Tuesday, but then otherwise you have them due on Sundays and Thursdays. And it tells you exactly what is due on that date, right? So Sunday, August 30th, you read Lunsford Chapter 1 and Least Rhetoric Then and Now, which the Leith reading is on Canvas. You'll complete discussion board 2. And then these are kind of the things that you'll see in terms of topics, activities, and videos in the last column. That's what you'll see in the module when you go to it. So you should look through all of those things, okay? And I set up the modules in a way to where, I'll show you. I set up the modules in a way to where everything you need to do is essentially in order, right? What is this? I don't even know. So you have the syllabus, you have the discussion board 1, you have an Everything's an Argument Chapter 1, which is in preparation for discussion board 2. You have the Leith reading, you have my web teach on Leith, and then you have discussion board 2 for Sunday, okay? So you're gonna see that every single week, okay? So essentially what you'll see is that like every discussion, every week is cut up into its own module, which is like 2 days. And one of the reasons I did that is because if I did this syllabus all on one day, it would just be too much and it would just be too jumbled. I wanted to cut it up and make it a little more palatable for you folks. So there's that. All right, so read through the syllabus at your leisure. Oh, hey, now the syllabus is normal. Oh, that's because I went to the Word document instead. Read through this syllabus. See, you know, what days we have holidays, when discussion boards are due, when final drafts of essays are due. The final draft of essay one will be due on the 27th. You know, we have the midterm, we have other fun stuff due. And then our last day of instruction, or our last day of assignments due, is Sunday, December 13th. So just some final notes. Weekly assignments are due on Thursdays and Sundays, respectively. Sundays. I know that'll be a typo on Canvas, but whatever. As long as I can fix it at some point in my life. Weekly assignments are due on Thursdays and Sundays, respectively, unless otherwise specified in blue highlighter. So again, everywhere where you see a blue highlighter, that's where it's slightly different. Like, so for example, Thanksgiving falls on a Thursday, you will have an assignment due that Wednesday instead of on Thanksgiving, and then Sunday is the observation of the Thanksgiving holiday, okay? So stuff like that, right? What else? Online readings can be found at our class Canvas Hub at fullcall.instructure.com or the app if you have the app. They can be obtained from the homepage under the module indicating the week or day that the assignment is administered or due. All other readings can be found, again, all the readings that aren't specified on Canvas are in Everything's an Argument or in Trick Mirror, okay? So keep that in mind. All right, and then frequently asked questions. I'll breeze through these. Some of them I've already answered, so if I've already answered them, I'll skip over them. Is it important that you know everything on the syllabus? Again, you don't have to remember 12 pages word for word, but this has like everything you need to know. It has when steps do, what books you need, what you need to do, how to contact me, how to find other helpful contacts on campus, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, so it's a great reference guide. It's your tool guide, it's your contract, right? It's here. Tentative syllabus means that it may change. So it doesn't mean I'm gonna add like 10 readings the night before, you know, a weekly module. Usually what it means is if our pace is a little bit different, I might change it a due date, or I might take a reading out or something like that. But it's generally, if I do, it's like once a semester. So it can change, but if it does, I will notify you well in advance. Let's see. Extra credit or makeup opportunities, already talked about those. If you're absent, it's your business. If you don't want to tell me why you're absent, guess what? You don't have to. Like I had horrific experiences in college where I felt the need to air my dirty laundry to, you know, my professors. And ultimately, I just kind of left it feeling weird and ashamed, right? Like, don't feel like you have to tell me. Those absences are your business. Just get caught up the best you can. And, make sure that your schedule fits with what's going on in this online course. Because I can't, I'm not your boss at your job. Like, I can't be like, oh yeah, your job's more important than this class, or this class is more important than your job. That is for you and your adult self to figure out, right? Like, I don't want to be responsible for anyone's life decision-making process. I'm just here to teach. So keep that in mind. What if you're uncomfortable in this course? We talk politics, we talk social issues, we talk argument, but we're talking about the ways of doing that in a healthy, helpful, respectful environment, right? So yes, there are gonna be issues that you disagree with. There are going to be social phenomena that we don't understand, right? That we're not entirely familiar with. And that kind of discomfort, that kind of learning is okay. You're gonna have readings where you go, I don't understand what this person's saying. This is, translated from ancient, this is translated from ancient Greece. Oy, 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 right? And that's totally normal. That discomfort is good discomfort. That's challenging yourself, right? If I made everything easy, we'd still be in fifth grade and you'd never get a college degree. I don't want that. I want you to, you know, really push yourselves and become critical thinkers. So that kind of discomfort is good. The kind of discomfort that is not okay is when someone is making you to feel unsafe, dehumanized, scared, harassed, discriminated against for any reason. That kind of discomfort is not okay. So I wanted to clarify those and to make sure that if the latter is happening, right? If someone is harassing you in some way, I can only address what I know about, and that needs to be brought to my attention immediately. If it's happening, you know, outside of the discussion boards or outside of the things that we do in the class and I'm not aware of it, you know, I can't do anything. So I, you know, if that's happening, please bring it to my attention and we will nip that in the bud immediately. All right. I kind of went backwards on that side, so I'm going to go to these other questions. Okay, how much homework will I have and will it be overwhelming? Well, this is all homework, right? So I try to keep my modules consistent in that you have, like, for every due date, every Thursday and Sunday, you have essentially, like, the Lunsford textbook chapter reading, the argument reading that's either on Canvas or in the Tolentino book, a web teach where I teach kind of the basics, synthesizing those concepts, and then your discussion board where you synthesize in more developed, in a more developed manner, those concepts as well. And then the major assignments, right, that happen, you know, once a week, once every other week or whatever. So it's significant, but it's not impossible. So keep that in mind. And everything I do is a step-by-step process. Like, I'm not the person that's like, here, write a senior thesis in an English 103 class. Like, I help guide you along the way. And what ends up happening is at the beginning, you feel scared and uncertain. By the end of the class, you feel like it was a piece of cake. And that's, you know, like, that's cool to me. Like, that works for me. If you ever feel like you're struggling or overwhelmed or anything like that, again, communicate with me. I'm kind of a jerk in my personal life, but like with you folks, I won't be a jerk. I will be, I'll help you as much as I possibly can, because I want to see you succeed. Like, I want you all to do well. And I want you to be not only successful in college, but successful critical thinkers. So why wouldn't I want to, you know, do everything I can for you to achieve that? Another one, I handed in all my assignments on time. Why did I get a C? Because a C is average work. Again, an A is an exceptional. It's above and beyond work. So if you're doing above and beyond work, you're earning an A. If you're doing average work, you're earning a C. If you're doing below average work that does not meet the basic requirements of this course, you will not pass this course, right? Keep that in mind. Textbook and readings, I already went over all that with you, but if you want kind of some, you know, ideas of where to get cheaper textbooks or cheaper readings, I posted some there. So if you want to look those over, you can. Let's see, regular and effective contact. That's like this online course thing. So essentially what that means is, like, just because we're not meeting in person, that I'm not like, I'm not throwing the smoke bomb down and then disappearing, right? Like, I will be here. I'll be answering emails. I'll be having Zoom office hours. I'll be doing all that stuff. I'll be present on Canvas, et cetera, et cetera. So I'm on Instagram too, right? Prof King FC English on Instagram. So, like, if there are plenty of ways of getting a hold of me if you need to. And it's probably, you know, in a weird way, it's kind of like going to be easier to get a hold of me this way than it would be like chucking it, you know, trekking it all the way to the 1200 building in my weird office that nobody can ever find. So there's that. And then finally, the odds and ends that I like to remind everybody about One, don't cheat, right? And it's, you know, in a classroom, I always say, like, oh, does everyone know what cheating is? Oh, yeah, we know what cheating is. We know what plagiarism is, right? Like, we're aware of that. We're in college. And then, of course, when it happens, when you catch the student who's plagiarized, they're like, I didn't realize that you couldn't cut and paste 75% of somebody else's essay and hand it in as your own. Like, really? That's not allowed, right? Like, that's not allowed. So I have faith in all of you that you know what cheating and plagiarism are, and I have faith in all of you that you're not going to do it. Because honestly, at the end of the day, the amount of effort you put into cheating and plagiarizing, I say this with 12 years of experience, right? The amount of effort that I've seen students who have plagiarized and cheated put into plagiarizing and cheating is more, if not the same amount of effort they could have put into just writing the essay and earning a better grade. So it's honestly, it's not only a waste of time, it's a waste of resources, right? Especially if you have to pay for those plagiarized essays, or, like, I don't know, talk to somebody that annoys you that's going to write the essay for you. Like, everything is economics, right? Like, everything is a give and take. So you might as well just, I don't know, actually, like, develop the writing skills that you're supposed to in this course and write your own authentic work, because the payoff is amazing, right? And the risk of cheating is just way too high. Turnitin.com, you know, when you submit to Canvas, and I'll show you, for those of you who are unclear, I'll show you how to submit to Canvas closer to when we get to submitting essay one. If I do it now and, you know, essay one's not due for over another month, everyone's going to forget. But just know that Canvas uses Turnitin for the major assignments. So that's how it'll kind of check authenticity. So keep that in mind. Blah, 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 blah. Withdrawal policies in week 12. So any 16-week course, if you're getting to week 12 and you're like, oh, I don't know, the withdrawal date is in week 12. So I'll remind you of that when we get closer to that date. And I believe the withdrawal date for a full refund is you have to do it within the first week. So keep that in mind. Again, no harassment for any reason. Gender, sexual orientation, gender identification, gender expression, religion, age, national origin, ethnicity, genetic information, ancestry, neurodiversity, marital status, military status, physical or mental status, ability status, anything, you know, if someone's harassing you, they do not get to do that. And that has to be brought to my attention. So make sure it is. Sexual harassment is something that I take incredibly seriously. I do not take lightly. I do not, suffer gender fools lightly, I guess I will say. And what I mean by that is, if you're going to say sexist language, if you're going to use language that makes any non-dominant gender feel as if it is a member of that group, as if they are being dehumanized or embarrassed or humiliated in any sort of way, that's not going to fly. And also, if you harass or even try to violate the physical boundaries of someone else, regardless of gender preference, that's not gonna fly. I need to be made aware of it if it's happening to you. There's information you can use. There are people other than me, if you don't feel comfortable contacting me, you'd rather kind of talk to a more anonymous face, you can go to health services, or you can contact health services here. You can contact campus safety. You can contact the Title IX office and our Title IX officer. All of those numbers are here. Because I have a zero tolerance policy for that kind of stuff. So just keep that in mind. But again, I can't help anyone unless I know what's going on. And people who are at these numbers to call, can't help anyone unless they know what's going on. So as uncomfortable, as terrifying as it can often be, if you are the survivor of a sexual assault, or if you're the recipient of sexual harassment or sexually charged language, as difficult as it is, I highly encourage you to get that discussion out, to get that documentation with as many people and sources as you can, so that you can be an advocate for yourself. Another thing I want to say about is disability support services. We do have DSS on campus, but again, because we're not on campus right now, a wrench is thrown in the learning for a lot of people who qualify for DSS. I'm going to do everything I can to accommodate, you know, in this online way. If you are a person who is registered with DSS, please make sure that I see your documentation so that I can provide those legally required accommodations for you, right? You are entitled to those under the law. They're not special treatment, as so many people who are stigmatized by society's ignorance of disability or neurodiversity tend to feel. They are legal requirements. So make sure I see that documentation. Otherwise, I cannot provide those accommodations. If you're a person who is not registered through DSS, but you think you learn differently, and you've never quite understood why, I highly, highly, highly recommend getting tested through DSS, because you cannot imagine the help that you will receive. I actually had a student, and this is totally, you know, I'm not going to mention who this student is or their name. Clearly, it's all anonymous, but I had a former student just contact me and say, you know, if you ever want me to talk to your classes about my DSS experience, because it helped me so much. And this student, they were the top student in my course. They won financial awards, and I'm not talking about financial aid, I'm talking about recognition awards for their work. They were just, the student was just amazing in every way. And they said, you know, if I had not had those accommodations through DSS, I don't know what I would have done. And that kind of, I mean, it terrifies me, right? Because it makes me think of all of the equally brilliant students out there who, because of society's ignorance and stigmatization of neurodiversity, of ability diversity, right? Of things like that, people don't get the accommodations that they legally deserve. So please, if you feel like you learn differently, check out DSS, because there's all sorts of things that you might qualify for that you don't even realize, right? What a lot of people don't know, and I, as somebody with mental illness as well, what I always like to tell people is, you know, things like depression, anxiety, mental health issues, those are ADA recognized disabilities. And so things like test taking anxiety, those can be accommodated if the person fits that need, right? If they test for it. So I highly recommend that you check that out if you are not already registered. And then if you are, or when you are registered, make sure that to receive those accommodations, that I know that I have that documentation. Because again, I cannot legally provide that those accommodations without that legal documentation. All right, and then the rest is just, you know, blah, 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 blah. So I'm gonna take it off share screen now. You have this syllabus, on Canvas, both on the first day, first item, first module, and under the syllabus button on your toolbar. So it's always there all semester for you to access. And you need to, because you need to know what assignments are due, when they're due, what's going on, yada, yada. I can't wait to read all of your discussion board posts and like officially meet you. And if you have any questions, not just in the first week, but especially in the first week, because that's when everything's kind of, you know, wild and crazy. Please feel free to contact me either office hours beginning on the 24th of August in Zoom, or through email, or to follow my Instagram page, Prof King FC English. Let's have a great semester and have a wonderful night. Bye.